ಈಗ ಕ್ವಿಕ್ ಆಗಿ ಈಚ್ ಕ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಮ್ಯಾಂಟಲ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಕೋರ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಆವರೇಜ್ ಕ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಕ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ನಾವು ಕ್ರಸ್ಟ್ So crust is made up of two layers. That they are what? Cl and cma. You know?
Cl
and cma. Purple. Crust is made up of two layers. That is Cl and cma. Cl and layer kehte hain. C is silicon plus aluminium. You know? सिलिकॉन प्लस अल्युमिनियम बर्कोर सीएल अंत ಐತಿ ಎಸ್ ಐ ಎ ಎಲ್ ಸಿಎಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿಆರ್ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಸಿಲಿಕಾನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ ಓಕೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಲಿಕಾನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ ಅಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಮಾ ಸಿಮಾ ಅಂದ್ರೆ
ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಂ
ಹಾ ಸಿಲಿಕಾನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಂ ಸೋ ಇಫ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸಿಲಿಕಾ ಇಸ್ देयर ಇಟ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಆನ್ ಬಿಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಮೋರ್ ಡೆನ್ಸ್ ओके इलेना अल्यूमियम मैग्नीशियम दे आर इन वेरी लेस क्वांटिटीज बट सिलिकेट्स आर वेरी इन अबंडेंस एंड द मच यस्ट सिलिका इंक्रीज अकाउंट होगा लास्ट मटेरियल बिकम्स डेंस 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 अंडरस्टूड ओके सो entire crust there is that is just 1% of earth's mass yes 1% of earth mass is containing all the known
elements
living beings just 1% mass we are living there you know ocean life agli and land life or ocean life both are and that 1% mass only entire plant everything you take marine life to go plant life to go literal enantare ivu mangroves avala eru land mat water alle iruttave so ella thondru it is just 1% of the mass is holding all the life known life in the universe yakara we don't know whether aliens are there there is no conclusive evidences gotagutha so now mantle very important mantle मेटल नंबर इट इज होल्डिंग 84% ऑफ अर्थ्स वॉल्यूम 84% ऑफ अर्थ्स वॉल्यूम एंड 67% ऑफ अर्थ्स मास बताएगा
60
हां 67% ऑफ अर्थ्स मास ಇಲ್ಲಿ 100 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ಸ್ ಅವರು ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಕ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ 100 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಟಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಲಿಥೋಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಏನು ಹಾ ಇಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇದೇನಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಂಟಿಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಟ್ ರೀಚಸ್ 100 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಯು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಾಕಿ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ರಾಕ್ಸ್ That is why it is called lithosphere. Litho is means what? Lithos means rocks, correct? Lithosphere. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅದೇನು ಡೆಪ್ತ್ ಅಪ್ ಟು 70 ಮೀಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಅಷ್ಟು 70 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಅಷ್ಟು ಬರ್ಕೊಟ್ರಿ ಕ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಹಾಂ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಬಿಯಾಂಡ್ 70 ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಟಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಟಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ 100 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಫಸ್ಟ್ 100 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಈವನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಟಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಲ್ ಲಿಥೋಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ದೆನ್ ಇದು ಅಪ್ ಟು ಏನು 670 ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಇಸ್ ಅಪರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಟಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಟಿಲ್ ಟಿಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ 500 to 670 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ಸ್ ಏನಂತಾರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಪರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಟಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ಥೆನೋಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಏನು ಆಸ್ಥೆನೋಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಎಲ್ಲಾನು ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಇರಬೇಕಿತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಬಟ್ ವೈ lower mantle is again solid, again outer core is liquid, and again inner core is solid.
Discontinuity
is also one reason. Formation of rock is also different, but just imagine what is the amount of material which is falling above, over and above these rocks. Already 670 kilometers of material is there.
Yes.
Don't you think though there is increase in temperature, there is also increase in pressure. That pressure will not leave these, allow the rocks to melt. Andre, though there is increase in temperature, that temperature doesn't result in melting of rocks, because there is also increase in pressure. Pressure will hold the rocks and in integrity, they will not become molten after beyond that. But there are other reasons why outer core is in molten state. I will tell those also. Well, I think. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಮೆಸೋಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಅಂತಾರೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಸ್ಥೆನೋಸ್ಫಿಯರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ 200 ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಸ್ಥೆನೋಸ್ಫಿಯರ್, ಬಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆಸೋಸ್ಫಿಯರ್. ಕೇಳ್ತಾ, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಸ್ಥೆನೋ, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆಸೋಸ್ಫಿಯರ್. ಲೋವರ್ ಮೆಂಟಲ್, ಲೋವರ್ ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆಸೋಸ್ಫಿಯರ್. ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಕ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ನಡುವೆ ಡಿಸ್ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಟಿ, ಮೋ ಡಿಸ್ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಟಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಲೋವರ್ ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಅಪರ್ ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ರೆಪಿಟಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೋವರ್ ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಟು ಔಟರ್ ಕೋರ್ ಗುಟನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ? ಆಮೇಲೆ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ದ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಸ್ಮಿಕ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಬೇಕು ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ದೆ. ದ ಅಸ್ಥೆನೋಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸಸ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದೋಸ್ ಸೆಸ್ಮಿಕ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ದ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಅಸ್ಥೆನೋಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಲೋ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಝೋನ್. As the entire mantle is called low velocity zone. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ? ಏನಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಅರ್ಥವೇಕ್ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲಿಥೋಸ್ಫಿಯರ್. ಜನರಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ರಾಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಟೆನ್ಷನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ದ ಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್, ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಇಸ್ ಅರ್ಥಕ್. ಅದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಲೋ ದ ಅರ್ತ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಅರ್ತ್ ಇಂಟೀರಿಯರ್. ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ರೀಚಸ್ after 100 kilometers, once it reaches asthenosphere, suddenly the speed or velocity of the waves, of the seismic waves, is decreasing, because it is a molten state. That is how no one has gone inside a 670 after 200 kilometers and found out lava. Oh, here is lava, that is why it is a molten state. No, they studied this velocity of the seismic waves, and since there is sudden decrease in S waves, ಎಸ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪಿ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ, ಪಿ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಕೆನ್ ದೇ ಕೆನ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಮೀಡಿಯಮ್, ವಾಟರ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಮ್, ಏರ್ ಅಲ್ಲೂ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತಾವೆ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಪಿ ವೇವ್ಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಎಸ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಕೆನ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೇ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ ಇನ್ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಮ್. ಎಸ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಅದನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ ನಾನು, ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಅರ್ಥಕ್ವೇಕ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಈಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ನಾವು ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್, the velocity of the seismic waves is decreasing when they enter the asthenosphere, because it is in semi molten state. It is not solid, it is not liquid. If it was liquid, S waves could never enter, P waves only will be entering. Now since both are entering, it is not completely liquid. That is why they call this molten state. It is about to melt, it is about to move, but still it is having solid, it is maintaining that integrity, and it is able to pass through both P waves and S waves. But the velocity of both waves is decreasing. That is why the asthenosphere is called low velocity zone. Gotaita? It is called low velocity zone. Then now core. Core coordinate beyond depth of 2900 kilometers. Outer core is there around 2180 kilometers. Again the heat increases. Okay, so again this is a molten state. Molten state, the outer core due to enormous pressure and also increase in heat. Outer core is a molten state and inner core is a outer core is the inner core is in plastic state. Under plastic state, under, you know what is plasticity? Plastic state of the outer antara
means it is not deformed.
No, that is not plastic. Yes, it is deformable, but after the pressure is
after when it gets deformed, it is not changeable. It means its shapes will not change.
Plastic is when it is able to regain its original shape after the pressure has been lifted. Tirita, andre ega something is there, sponge. If you give something on it, it will deform, and once if you remove it, it regain that time. Tirita.
Sir, mesosphere which steps?
In
mesosphere.
Mesosphere. It is in solid state only. Okay, that is why. Andre here there is increase in pressure agutte, but again there is increase in domination of temperature and pressure. Yavadu dominate aagirutte, if temperature is dominating, it will melt the rocks.
If
pressure is,
if it regains its position, then it is elastic.
Elastic, right? Plastic is not. Yes, you are right. Plastic is what?
It will not regain its.
Once it is deformed, it will not
regain its.
Okay, yes, you are right. Plasticity is right. No, plasticity is, I'll tell you, up to some extent it will regain its shape. Ega nodi bucket tagori adanu vatri, once you remove the pressure, again it is coming back. Adanu mel hatti tuliri adu, once it is broken, it will not come to original shape. Plasticity is where some amount of elasticity is still there, only to some extent it will regain its shape. Beyond that, if force is applied, then it will deform completely, permanently. Understood? So we both arrived at the right answer. Because see, until he challenged me, I also did not remember the original concept. Understood? Now, inner core, how is it? Inner core, it is around 1 to 20 kilometers. 1 to 20 kilometers. It is in plastic form. The inner core is in plastic form. Adhe plastic form andre here pressure is dominating. Though heat wants to melt it, the pressure is keeping it in solid form. So it is made up of iron and nickel. Knife layer antara enantara
knife layer
andre nickel and iron, NiFe. Okay, NiFe, knife layer. Temperature goes up to 6000 degrees Celsius.
Temperature in asthenosphere
It is around 3500 degrees Celsius. Amele in asthenosphere it is not so much, it is 1500 degrees Celsius. 1500 degrees Celsius. That is why it is able to melt the rock. Okay. Math here. See, the core constitutes only 15% of Earth's volume. Yes, true? 15% of Earth's volume. But 32.5% of mass. See the amount of space and the material packed into it. That is why it is the densest material. It is 13.6 grams per centimeter square. Core is also called as barysphere. Yeah, that barysphere. Temperature hang increase anta adu barthodu. How does temperature in earth interiors increase? First 100 kilometers, every kilometer 12 degree changes. Yes, 12 degree change. 12 degree per kilometer, first 100 kilometers. Then next 100 to 300 yen idella, next 300 kilometers. 2 degree per kilometer as change at the temperature. Now you can calculate exactly how much is there in asthenosphere. And beyond it, every kilometer 1 degree Celsius will increase. Earth is composition of purple, na? What is composition of earth? Even temperature calculated, but see, though the temperature is increasing with the depth, but the rate of increase in temperature is decreasing. Confused one, but rate of change of temperature, not rate. First 100 kilometers, say every kilometer 12 degree change again. But next 300 kilometers only 2 degrees there is change, and beyond it every kilometer only 1 degree is changing. So isn't it rate of change in temperature is decreasing? It was 12 degree, then it is 2 degree, then it is 1 degree. But temperature is constantly increasing only. It is 12 or same somewhere it is 20 degree, and if you go below how much depth you go, the temperature is always higher than the previous level. design bro. OSI CSPM. OSI CSPM. Okay, O on the
oxygen.
Yes, oxygen. With oxygen, na? Oxygen is 46%. No, highest level. Then 27% around. Then it is 8.13%. It's 5%. Percentages are not important, but still, okay? 3.63%. 2.85. Then 2.62. Then it is 2.09. Ikade, this is iron. This is iron. Iron is 35% in entire earth. When you consider only crust, oxygen is oxygen and silica are dominating. Right? So they are making how much up to 82%. Around 80% of earth crust is oxygen and silica. Oxygen and silica. But when you consider entire earth, it is iron and oxygen. Iron is 35%, oxygen is 30% again, silicon is 15%, 30, nickel is 12, 2, nickel is 2, sulfur is 2, calcium is 1, and aluminum is 1%. Okay? Go ahead. Hardest test and the birth. MOS MOH. MOS hardness test or scale. Okay. Scale or number test. And then there is 1 to 10 numbers are there. 1 is the least hard and 10 is
most
hardest. Okay. First one is talc. Last one is, which is the hardest material, what material to the diamond? Diamond's hardness is 10. 7 is quartz. So, you also should know about hardness scales. Know which, what number is assigned to which element. Okay, it starts from talc. Have you heard talcum powder?
Yes.
And it is least hard. Okay, I like it. Talc is also a rock actually. Soap, stone or type of thing. If you rub it, it will become powder. Add it in. Tamp. Six most abundant minerals in earth crust. Six most abundant minerals. Even no? Elements. Yes. These are elements. Elements are there. Elements of minerals are different. No? Elements are there. They are in pure form. Their oxygen is a pure form. Only single. It has not combined with anything else. R.E.T. Andre, when we say oxygen is abundant, it doesn't mean that you are still oxygen, earth crust, or there are no mal oxygen, or ill oxygen, or the other fact that you are going to dig one thing about the land and get a lot. Oxygen is there, but it has combined with so many other elements. If you take the weight of oxygen in each and every material, you will find that oxygen is in abundance because it has combined with every non mineral which is there in earth crust. They are not available in free form, means element is a primary element. Okay, it is not combined first star. When we start talk about compounds, what are compounds? They are group of elements. When to silicon dioxide, silicon aluminum type, aluminum dioxide. So oxygen is combined with other elements, then it is becoming a compound. Now what are minerals? Then ఈ డిఫరెంట్ కంపౌండ్స్ కూడి అగ్రిగేట్ ఆఫ్ ఆ సిస్టమేటిక్ స్ట్రక్చర్ ఏదైతే ఒక ఒక మినరల్స్ తంత they are having definite chemical structure. Okay, they are containing two or more elements compounds enadavo or minerals definition bartare minerals are having two or more elements andre silicon dioxide ante irabodu. Okay, ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ ಸಿಲಿಕಾನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂತಾನೆ ಇರಬಹುದು ಹಿಂಗೆ ಸೊ ಟೂ ಆರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಜಾಯಿನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಅ ಮಿನರಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಕಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಕಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಸೊ ಅಂತದ್ರೊಳಗ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಅಬಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಮಿನರಲ್ಸ್ ಯಾವ್ದಾವ ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಬರ್ಕೊ ಫೆಲ್ಸ್ಪಾರ್
ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಅಬಂಡಂಟ್ ಮಿನರಲ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಇದನ್ನು ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಇದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೆಲ್ಸ್ಪಾರ್ ಕ್ವಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ third one is pyroxene fourth one is amphibole fifth one is mica mica is not thorbanin mica andre eno thorbanin ne in ganna mone ಈಗ ಅರ್ಥ ಫುಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಒಳಗಿದ್ದೆಲ್ಲ ನೋಡ್ತೇನೆ
Understood? Isn't it interesting? Gotaitala how things are formed and why such layers are there, why discontinuities are there, what are the discontinuities, what is the physical structure of crust, mantle, and why if it is in molten state, why solid state, okay? And what is the different layers called? Asthenosphere, mesosphere, perisphere, and sometimes not only internal core, inner core, outer core, are only not called perisphere. Entire below crust, whatever is there, entire thing also sometimes is referred to as perisphere.
Sir, iron is
used in
avoided.
Iron
comes in what? Mica?
See, they are minerals. Minerals are different than elements. Elements are, I have already written. Once you combine, okay, this is having what? Feldspar is having silicon and iron. Iron. Feldspar is nothing but made up of silicon and oxygen. Silicon and oxygen. Like that, quartz is made up of different materials. So quartz you will find where? Sand and granite. Sand varatha, river sand alla varatha. Adara shiny object irutha gotha. Sana 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 shiny piece. That is nothing but quartz. Even in granite, if you find shiny things polished over there some elements of shiny elements are there. That is nothing but quartz. It is very hard. That is why granite has no vitrified tiles beda aate because vitrified tiles are not that strong, but granite is very strong. It is thickness is also a lot.
Vitrified tiles are made tiles.
Yeah, they are manufactured. Yeah, that is why they are able to come in so many different designs and all. Okay, our shine or the care of the stair. It's artificial. Tell you that? Shall we move next or you want to take little break? Break the one or something?
Yeah. Pause.
Pause.